In the wake of the recent shooting at a Planned Parenthood center in Colorado Springs, abortion advocates are once again pointing the finger at the pro-life movement, claiming that our overheated rhetoric is somehow responsible for inciting violence. It's far from clear that gunman Robert Louis Deer, who appears to be deeply disturbed, was motivated by opposition to abortion. But even if he was, the connection Planned Parenthood and other abortion advocates are trying to draw between his act of violence and our peaceful movement just doesn't hold up. Those who try to link such violence with the pro-life movement are essentially arguing that it would never have crossed anyone's mind that abortion is wrong and something must be done about it if the pro-life movement weren't saying so. But in fact, almost everyone is at least uncomfortable with abortion, and not because they've heard a pro-life speech or read a pro-life pamphlet. It's the very nature of abortion, snuffing out the life of a tiny human being at the most vulnerable stage of human life, that troubles our conscience. That's why all but the most hardened supporters of legal abortion admit it's at least an agonizing choice. That's why people like my father, Joe Scheidler, were inspired to create a movement to confront the injustice of abortion through peaceful activism. And that, the violent nature of abortion, is what has provoked a few individuals, typically with little or no connection to the pro-life movement, to resort to violence themselves. Nevertheless, we're hearing a lot today about an alleged escalation in pro-life rhetoric, with escalating violence tracking along with it. But in fact, pro-life messaging has actually grown softer over the years, even as the pro-life movement has grown. Protest signs reading "baby killer" and "abortion is murder" have largely been replaced by signs reading "we're here to help" and "I regret my abortion." An entire branch of the pro-life movement has emerged devoted to equipping pro-lifers to talk about abortion with civility and compassion. Pro-life activists outside abortion clinics today are more likely to be engaged in silent prayer than chanting slogans over a megaphone. As for the claim of escalating violence, the abortion industry's own figures show that violence is at an all-time low, down dramatically from the 1990s. And those figures are padded with things like crank calls and such harassment as holding a peaceful prayer vigil. But even taking the abortion industry's dubious statistics at face value, when you consider how many hundreds of thousands of Americans take part in pro-life activism every year, from the huge March for Life in Washington, D.C., to the daily prayer and sidewalk counseling going on outside abortion clinics coast to coast, it's clear that the pro-life movement is a movement of peace. If pro-life rhetoric, which for pro-abortion radicals includes even the factual statement that abortion stops a beating heart, were really so likely to incite violence, it's puzzling that anti-abortion violence is in fact so very rare. Now, this isn't the first time in American history those seeking to end social injustice have been denounced because some adherents of their view resorted to violence. When abolitionist John Brown and his followers slaughtered a group of slavery advocates in their sleep at Pottawatomie Creek and later launched a murderous attack on the arsenal at Harper's Ferry, slaveholders and their political allies blamed opponents of slavery like Frederick Douglass, William Lloyd Garrison, and Abraham Lincoln for inciting violence with their rhetoric about the evils of slavery. Nobody today thinks Douglass, Garrison, and Lincoln should have kept silent about the injustice of slavery. Neither will we today be cowed into shutting up about abortion because of the violent acts of a few. We all want to live in a peaceful society, but how can we ever hope to achieve that goal when we tolerate violence against unborn children, the human family's most innocent and vulnerable members? We in the pro-life movement will continue to speak the truth about abortion precisely because we abhor violence and cherish peace, which begins for each one of us with peace in the womb.